You're watching UNICEF Television. The Democratic Republic of the Congo is one of the hardest places on earth for a child to grow up. It's the second poorest country in the world, where more than half the adult population either never attended school or only completed primary school. Nearly half the children that enter primary school do not finish. Yet, for 12-year-old Naifa Kabeya and her preschool mentees, there is hope. In 2008, UNICEF, in collaboration with the Child to Child Trust, launched a pilot initiative, Getting Ready for School, a Child to Child Approach, a cost-effective supplementary model to early childhood learning programs where older children mentor preschool-age children, teaching them the basics of math, reading, and writing through interactive play so they have a head start preparing for primary school.
It's important to help the younger kids so they can avoid having problems in first grade. If they're not well prepared when they go to first grade, they'll never ask questions and won't participate in class.
The child-to-child program was designed with an equity-based and cost-effective approach to early childhood development, aimed at increasing on-time enrollment, promoting school readiness, decreasing early dropout rates, and improving academic performance. By the time a child is 5 years old, many of the skills he or she will need to do well in school are already developed. During this crucial time of growth, girls and boys need to learn by watching, listening, and interacting with positive people in their lives.
I like Naifa because she teaches us how to sing and count.
In class, I love to read, write, and sing.
The child-to-child program is also bolstering the achievement of Millennium Development Goal 2, universal primary school education, by making every effort to reach the most marginalized children and bridging the gender gap. For those who can't logistically get to school, the child-to-child program is coming to their homes. Here, in the rural outskirts of Kinshasa, mentors gather with their mentees at a child's home, where they learn the same exercises and skills as if they were in a regular classroom. For these children, this is the only way for them to have any exposure to preschool education. While the program is practically free for the participants, the challenge of school fees for primary and secondary students remains unresolved.
If I couldn't go to school, I'd be like my friends in my neighborhood. They sell juice and water in the street.
Naifa's mother is raising 6 children and sells bread for a living at 50 cents a loaf on commission, a common job for women in Kinshasa. Yet, Naifa's school fees alone cost $100 a year.
I'm alone now. My husband passed away last year. Sometimes the children are out of school because I don't have enough money for the school fees. It's quite difficult.
However, as a reward for Naifa's enthusiasm and dedication to mentoring children in her community, her school fees have been reduced. UNICEF continues to work with the Congolese government to find a way to provide universal education for all Congolese children.
This year, the president of the Democratic Republic of the Congo decided to abolish school fees for the first 3 years of primary school in some provinces. This is good progress.
The child-to-child pilot program has gone above and beyond its original goals. It has laid a strong foundation for preschool children to be prepared for primary school, as well as teaching preteen students about responsibility and compassion, and empowering them to develop invaluable leadership and communication skills they will continue to cultivate through adulthood. This is Vivian Siu reporting for UNICEF Television. For more information, go to unicef.org. Unite for Children.